Operational report. Repairs complete on Guam. Sydney. Well, the Electra, yeah, she's damaged. Contact report. Recon Fukuoka, Langkawi, and Gifu. Kill credit. Contact report. Kill credit. Whoa, good job. More kill credit. Here come the Chinese 5th Corps. Replacements taken. These are the repairs complete. Oh, these are the PT boats that supposedly were damaged, right? So something must be wrong with that mechanism. I withdrew them while they were partially repaired, and I guess the AI doesn't like that for whatever reason. So they now show up as repaired. Upgrade. Oh, Tokiyama, whatever the heck that is. The Indian Frontier 44 Battalion. But it's not 1944 yet. Oh, the dates are a little bit screwed up in this game. Reinforcement Portland, Balboa, Alameda, and Eastern USA. Let's take a quick look at Tokuyama. Here is... Okay, the Assam Rifles. So this is now a militia force for 1944. Table of Organization. Looks pretty much the same, just I need a whole bunch of replacements. Oh, crud. So it really weakened us. Now the assault strength is only 12. Well, I'm glad it's not a garrison force, or I could be taking some partisan attacks right now. No submarines are available in Hong Kong. The Sui Tao, yeah, we're just defending ourselves right now. Trying to bring down that fatigue level, and it has. We've brought it down a little bit. So Chow Chow is just abandoned. It's going to get bombed until we do something about it. The 41st Air Anti-Aircraft Artillery Regiment is moving over. Going to take another 3 days to get there. Shanghai, we have two submarines in. Greyback will be repaired. We're sending Balao back out to Shikoku Station. The number of PT boats here? Okay, since we have PT boats... Oh, eight more days to wait. Okay, the PT boats have returned at Fusan, so they showed up as repair. So they... I guess the AI just needs one day to recover, whatever. So I'm going to have to cycle through all the PT boats here just to make sure which ones are... What's the best way to call them? Ghosts? It says 16 are here, and there are 16 here. That's okay. This one says 9, and can we transfer any of them? Well, we can transfer all 9 of them, so these are probably legitimate PT boats. Some of these other ones... Well, these... No, they aren't all... There's 11 here, and there's 5, and it says there's 16. So there's 5 of... What else to say? Ghosts in the machine. So I'll transfer the... Oops. Okay, I'll grab them out of Fusan. Ah, it's right. Okay, 168 and 176 is from Fusan. Now we'll try to grab them back from Fusan and see that we don't get as many back. That's fine. So we'll let them, there are four under, we'll let them repair. A neat thing to look at is, we'll call up all the ships and say, show the ones under repair. Oh, well, gee, they're all under repair, right? They should be in dock somewhere, like this. Guam, Brisbane, Pearl Harbor. Yet some of these show up as in the task force. So that's how you know that, and it says 0 days required for repair. So that's how you kind of know which ones, and here are the docks, all the ports. These are legitimate repairs, and these are not. So it's a good way to find out which ones are phantoms or apparitions that need to be dropped into dock and returned next turn. We're starting the march on Kerume. We're going slowly to allow the infantry to backfill behind us. I wouldn't want to be into Kerume and then have the enemy cut off our line of supply behind. The AO is feeling really insulted. The AI wouldn't bomb it last turn. It attacked Kochi, but did not attack the ship docked there. We'll leave it out for a little while longer, see if we can't attract any flies. Here we have, moving up, these are the transports. They have arrived. They've been moving 6 per turn. Now, we are 11 hexes away from Kochi. I guess if we move 6 and then 5, we could be 2 turns, 2 days. We could be right on top of Kochi. But I'm not going to do that. The last time we hit Kochi, we approached from this point, 3 hexes away. We managed to get in, unload a god-awful amount in 1 day, and leave the next day. Well, this time we have even more. We've got a million, I'd say all, close to 2 million in supply with the convoys here. So what I am going to do is we're going to move up to here, only 4 hexes up. Actually, we'll move 3, and then we'll try to move 3, and then 5, and then bam, we'll take an extra day in. The reason I'm doing this, okay, so we'll take the amphibious. So instead of going all the way to Kochi, we'll go 1, 2, 3. This will give a chance for the carriers to catch up. They are 6 away. So 3, we'll put it right there. Put them right on top of us for escort. Then we go to close escort, and then we make their final run. It'll give these guys a chance to move in too. Well, that's not a big deal. They could probably meet us up here. So that one's going to meet up here. And this one, well, we'll backtrack to meet that. We've got the escort cruisers and whatnot coming up. They'll meet up, same place. So we'll all gather together here, move once into enemy territory, and then make the final sprint into Kochi. Another Indian base force moves up the road, the Hangkau Railway. Oh, are these guys even moving? Yeah, they're on the railroad to Benoit. At Benoit, the catapult, I'll call it, catapult. Headquarters arrives. We launch towards Compon Chenang, set all to march, and then cancel out. Now we got the Chinese. Well, there they go, right? There they go. They're now able to use the road. Kind of cheap, right? Oh, well. Here's the rest of the Chinese corps coming up. Another 9,000. 9,500 coming up the railroad. Corps engineer, we're heading for Phnom Penh. We're going to divert. Let's see if we can't get down to Benoit. More arriving. Okay, we'll drop them into strategic. Drop them into strategic. Out for Phnom Penh and cancel. So everybody else is going. We have aircraft transferring through. P-40 Liberators, they're recovering. Let them recover. Then we'll send them onwards. South, we have 2 submarines. Oh, I guess I didn't send them out. Okay, I forgot. Send them out this turn. Quiet, nothing happening. Aloha Star, just bombing away. Mumien, we have the why don't we just set everybody to move down Bangkok. Set all and set all to march. Then we'll cancel this one and let everyone continue past us. There we go. No additional forces at Rangoon. These are the continuous supply convoys arriving. No additional reinforcements, Shwebo. Let's check the army at Akyab. Still too heavy. Not gonna do it, man. Can we disperse some of it? Nope, we're still at the 20 mark here. Still at the 20 mark, so looks like we need another turn to recover. No additional reinforcements at Chittagong. No additional reinforcements at Calcutta. Oh, Impal, here's the command headquarters. All right. March, not Mandalay, Shwebo. March down to Shwebo. It'll give a chance to recover those 78 disabled units. Gosh, how do we have that many? Escorts arrive, returning to Colombo, finally. No activity. The convoy has arrived, Bombay. We've got, that's another 60,000 dropping here. We have two convoys finishing their unloading at Karachi before heading back. Nothing happening. No convoy at Abadan. No additional forces at Aden. No reinforcements South Africa, but a convoy is on the way back. Submarine check. Greenling, we know about, nobody else has been damaged. Checking the endurance. Fuel wise, we have K17. That's K17, isn't it? I can barely read that. I think it's K17 is returning. Salmon is returning. Gar returning. Silversides also returning. And Runner. So no additional submarines getting the recall. Checking for torpedoes. Permit was the only submarine that fired, and she still has weapons to continue her patrol. Submarine still detected off Cooktown, another one near Milne Bay, moving northwest, so it looks like might be leaving the area. Oh, finally, look at that. Everybody's loaded up, ready to go. We're leaving the last Navy force behind. Just a little bit of aviation support for the base. Now we have two groups here, 64 and 31. That's 95 ships. Can you, oh my god. And we'll take the ones that are loaded. Yep. That's another, god awful clicking. Yeah, I know. So we're going to click the hell out of all this. Great. What, fortuitously, we actually have exactly 5 destroyer escorts that came along. Can you believe that? Perfect. Now we just have to avoid a collision on the way home, destroying something. So we'll set for Guam. We'll take it up to, let's see, where is it? Right about here. And then we'll just automatically retire to Guam. So we've got to get through these submarines here, possible submarine here, possible submarine here, with only 5 ships and no collisions. Well, it might happen. Brisbane, we're docked, unloading, and we're not docked. The transports are in. Okay, we'll get rid of the escorts. Do we have enough to dock? Still can't dock. Okay, we'll transfer enough into dock. Here's the tankers going out. They're past the submarine zone, so we'll take the escorts back. At Sydney, we have a heavy cruiser and Medusa repair vessel is out of refit. Now, the cruiser, I'm going to try to get to Guam, but I don't know what to do with the Medusa. We have a repair vessel sitting at Townsville, but there's not much activity here. I originally had the repair vessel at Brisbane. But there's not a hell of a lot to do here either. Unless, of course, we're running out to Loggy, but we are. I don't suspect we're going to be doing too many of those runs. To Loggy, we have, on a side note, we have Sipora. Okay, we'll form one transport. We'll send the Sipora. Where are you, dummy? Did I miss? Ah, Sipora. Here, it's empty. Okay, we'll send to Lunga. The rest of the group, we're just going to sit here and wait for it to come back. Because Sipora has to come back here with the aircraft anyway, so there's no point in leaving. We might as well just wait for her here. Sipora's already empty. That should be enough to pick up two planes, right? Really? Anyway, where to place the repair vessel? I don't think I need it at Brisbane because we have a dry dock there, so we did have a little use of one at Panape, and we have one stationed at Panape, we have one stationed at Guam, and we have stationed at Iwo Jima, where the main ships are. So I'm at a loss as where to place this thing. Do I need it? We have one at Suva to take care of anything down there. I guess I'm going to move it up to Guam along with the heavy cruiser, simply because we could always use more to repair. The more repair vessels we have, the more little small damage ships we can enter. So yeah, I'll take them out, and we'll sail around with the heavy cruiser Exeter and go for Guam. On a side note, the small dock here has, we're going to repair the tankers, the ones that can't fit in the dock. We'll try to repair them. By the time they're repaired, we'll have room on the dock to unload them. Jackson's been sitting here for God knows for what, 80 days, 60 days already. I think that the dock is just too small for her, and she really needs, she ripped her bottom out, and she really needs a bigger dock. So what I'm going to do is I'm taking her out of here. We're going to have these guys, let's go critical, let's really try to get these guys fixed and out. We'll go high, and high. I'll get the President Jackson out, and we're going to try to move her over to the Sydney dock, which is empty. The bigger the dock, the more repair points are available, and the faster she should repair. West Coast, Panama, pardon me, we have another transport, Robin Wentley. Arrives, we'll form her up. She's got a good long range on her. We don't need her. Oops. We don't need her for any other stopover, so I'm going to load her and send her right to Guam. Maybe she'll even make it all the way to. We'll see. Maybe she might even make it directly to Japan. She's got the range for it. Several groups have arrived, heading for Pearl Harbor. Pearl Harbor, we have this LST loaded. Didn't I tell you to undock last time, man? Go! Well, hold on. Loading troops? Oh, God. So, that's what happened. It was still loading troops last time. Somehow, at 100%, it doesn't know how to load the last little bit, so you have to go to manual to stop it. Okay. Now, go. So we lost a whole turn while you couldn't decide what you wanted to do. No other transports, no other replenishment coming in, no aircraft going past. Here comes the damaged carrier. She'll be in very soon. Let's see. Damage-wise, we have... we're working on... We have 93,000 out of 100,000 tons assigned. So we're going to have to shift things around in order to accommodate the damaged carrier. But the damaged carrier is very valuable. Even more valuable than the battleships. West Coast, we have a new reinforcement at Alameda, sending it over to San Francisco. No other reinforcements on this side. At San Francisco, the tankers are just finishing off. We're undocking and sending off to Guam. We have, is it one or two? No, one squadron for going for Guam. Now, We've used up a lot of points, a few hundred points, buying out the Australian units. And I've said I want, the important part is trying to get the land units out of Shanghai. There's still some need for fighter aircraft, and these little ones here, it's only 9 points per squadron, so I'm going to buy out a couple of the Corsair squadrons. We have a nice one in within house, so it's 9 points done. We're gonna load it up with aircraft. Oops, we can't load it. Well, we'll try. Oops, not this one. Oh, this one's about to leave. September, lots of time. So Corsair, 3-4, and jam it up. Okay, we've got them jammed. Right now the pilots are training up, they're bomber pilots. We're using them to train for experience. We're gonna buy out another one, the 217 and 218 squadron. Both of them are 9 points. Why am I buying them now? Well, I've got two AKVs in port. These are the ships which can transport fighter squadrons without dismantling them. So when they land, they can fly right away. So I've wanted to use... Oh, I may as well use them here. So I'm going to form up the two AKVs, transport. That's their purpose in life. So we'll load up fighter, and head out for... I'll put them under Iwo Jima. They can land. They don't need to be reassembled. They can land. That's the whole point. They can land without requiring reassembly. What else have we got here? We have some damaged ships. Oh, these are my special forces. Oh, yes. I've got more, but there's two, four, there's six of them right here. That's not a small little group. So they're all loaded. They're fast. I could even send the AV with them. It's another 2800. It's same speed. You know what? For this trip, I'll send them. Normally, I save it for resupplying small bases like Iwo or Guam or something like that. Well, no. I'll keep what I planned. I'll keep this one back because the AVs can only carry supplies. The AKs can carry anything. So this is another 56,000. I'm going to send this one down to Brisbane. Even though we've taken it, we've denuded it of forces, Brisbane still, Australia still probably, I think it needs a little bit per month. So I'll send it. Where is it? 1, 2, 3, 2. We'll keep a trickle going, and that's what the 17, my special forces are, I'm going to use. There we go. 2, and we're gone. I've got another group of 17 special forces coming back, but they're kind of straggled. They're kind of spread out here, and that's all I need. A few of them, a couple of convoys per month. So 50,000, 100,000 a month is probably where I'm. Will be way more than they need, but it can never hurt. Lastly, we have one base force here, the 156th, ready to go. I have one more transport here, the George Himes. We're going to load this baby. We're going to try to load it. We won't have enough. Yeah, we'll load about 47%. Okay, that's fine. We'll load and we'll sit and we're going to wait here because we've got another one coming in tomorrow. That's going to be 47 plus 47 and 94%. Maybe we'll have another, and maybe we'll have one of these ships ready to go too. So here comes another destroyer tender. Another one of my special... see? These speedy ones, speedy. But we're in no rush. So I'll return them, repair them, and then send them for Australia. The Cascade is a destroyer tender, and it's one of my special forces. I'll mix it up with the AV and have them go off to resupply somebody. Lastly, we have a fighter squadron, a night fighter squadron, arriving in the east. The components are already, some of them are already over at Chichijima. Okay, we'll fly it. We'll order these to escort, train on the way. Oops, at 5,000. Let's see, what have we got pilots wise? We've got some, not great, learners. Let's grab some more. Whew, these are pretty bad pilots down here. Let's see, if we grab them from the top, we don't see much action, so I don't foresee a need for highly skilled pilots. Let's grab them out of the middle. We only need one. Really? We need one? That's three. Well, that's four. It's only a detachment, so we have four pilots. We don't have any replacements because these aircraft are no longer made. We're August. They stopped making them in July. So what we have is, that's what we get. That's all we have. Let's go down to San Francisco. On the island, here come the New Zealanders to unload their brigades. The Kapahi picked up an air group, a replenishment group, as it passed through. Right, they're buffaloes and they're training bomber pilots, but we'll switch them out for fighter pilots before we send them back into battle. Other ones coming in, lots of units coming through. Just one finishing off here. Repair-wise, we only have a couple of ships finishing off the repair. Santee is going to probably just finish her repair right here. No need to send her back to Pearl Harbor. May as well put it right here. We have transports coming in. These are the ones that missed the group here. Another bunch that are missing the group aren't going to make it in with this run. We're just going to head over to Guam, dump off for the next one. Lots of ships that are going to miss the convoy run in to Kochi. That's okay. Dump off here. They can go back for more. Wow. No night attacks. No night torpedo attacks. Nothing with the submarines. Morning air attack, Fukuoka. Fighter sweep. We get one lightning. Got 1-0. Enemy bombs again on Chow Chow. No hits. Afternoon phase. Lots of contact reports. Something moving around in the Java Sea. Air raid, Fukuoka. Whoa, he's got 13 fighters in. And we have 47 escorts. But we lose a couple of them. Darn it. They did their job, shot down four enemy aircraft. Several more non-combat units hit, disabled. Akyab, bombing practice. We get a couple of hits there. Langkawi, bombing practice. We destroy one non-combat and disable four support squads. Another support squad destroyed. And one engineer squad. Bombing, Akyab. Well, I'm hoping we can keep the disruption high enough, even though we're not attacking. Fukuoka bombed again, but this time there are five defending fighters. We shoot down only two, and we lose an escort Soviet fighter. Fukuoka bombed again. No defenders this time, and we only get one disabled non-combat support squad. We bomb again, and it's great to see. That's what happens when you have 1,000 fighters on Fusan. You can keep sending escorts. Another bombing raid with 19 Beauforts and 16 escorts. Keep the enemy off of them, bombers. The Mitchells hit and damage, disable three more squads, and seven more hit by the Bolos and Mitchells. Mitchells bomb again, miss.